We apologize for that. This is the story that has just aired. Scientists from Romania, in partnership with Ugandan innovators, developed a cube atomizer, new technology in Uganda, which will help spraying large places like markets in a wake of COVID-19 pandemic. The machine has been presented to the officials and the Ministry of Health, who say they will analyze how effective it can be. Now, the National Unity Platform NUP party leadership has objected to the government's move to introduce 7 new taxes in the forthcoming financial year. In a press briefing this morning, the NUP spokesperson Joel Senyonyi said that the new taxes were only intended to exploit Ugandans and deplete their hard-earning incomes, yet government agencies have failed to account for these revenues. Let's have the story.
Ugandans want accountability for their tax money. They want services delivered.
At the beginning of this month, Finance Minister Matia Kasaija tabled several tax amendment bills before Parliament. Among the proposed taxes is a 12% levy on internet bundles, 30% tax on each liter of beer, 30% on rental income, among others.
I want to move that the excise duty amendment bill 2021.
The other proposed tax is on exports of processed gold and processed minerals, wheat, leaf tobacco, maize bran, fish meal and milling byproducts, among others.
But they are not amending them downwards, they are amending them upwards. So the government intends to increase taxes during such a trying moment.
But we are bothered by the continuous increase in taxes. And I'll point out some. There was a proposal to levy a 12% tax on internet bundles. There was a proposal to shoot up the rental tax by 10%. A proposal to put a tax of 100 shillings per kilogram of wheat grain, now this is food, tax on import exports like fish meal, wheat bran, maize bran, and milling byproducts. And there was also that ridiculous proposal, car license of 200,000 shillings and 50,000 shillings for border borders, and a plethora of others. We're not opposed to the collection of taxes. We need taxes to run our country. But what kind of taxes?
The National Unity Platform party leadership says the proposed taxes are too high for the ordinary Ugandans, yet they seem not to be getting value for their money.
Maybe increasing taxes would not be a very bad thing. But what is the value for this money? Ugandans are paying very heavy taxes. But where is the service delivery? So again, we're not opposed to the levying of taxes. But where is the value for that tax money? In some countries, when you go to Europe, there's countries where incomes of people are taxed to the tune of 50% and even more. But you see, the citizens there, even though they feel the pinch, but they're not so much bothered to pay 50% of their incomes in taxes. Why? Because they know that when they are sick and they go to a government hospital, they will be attended to by professionals, there will be good health care. They know that when they take their child to a government school, their child will get quality education. Infrastructure development keeps happening. But also, there is accountability for this tax money.
Joel Senyonyi, the spokesperson, adds that the government must put enough effort to ensure that all taxes collected by the Uganda Revenue Authority are accounted for.
As we ask Ugandans to pay more taxes, one, can we account for this money to Ugandans? Number two, can we deliver services? So that when tomorrow government comes up and says we want to increase taxes, it is justifiable. Currently, it is not. You go to many of our hospitals, mothers are giving birth on the floor. They're there with their newborn babies. When you go to many of these government-aided schools, children are studying under trees. When it rains, there is no schooling. When you look at our infrastructure, etc., etc., where is the service delivery? So these are questions that we have. And we are asking government to tread carefully, account for our money, but we want to see value for our money.
Meanwhile, the National Unity Platform is set to have their party retreat this weekend at the party offices in Kamocha. Story compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Kampala.